conduct the orchestra. If you want us to go loud, like this, side to side. If you want us to go soft, side to side. If you want to go slow, if you want to go fast, you know, it's up to you, it'll seven. Okay? Just be led, be led. Okay, are you ready? Can everyone just give them some encouragement? What's your name? Caleb Strickland. Where are you from? What church are you part of?
I'm part of Maranatha.
Fantastic. And married?
Oh, yes, my beautiful wife. She wanted to do this.
Okay, she wanted to do it, but no, she's not. And how many kids do you have?
Three kids.
Fantastic. Let's give them a big round of applause. Turn around. Oh no, yeah, let's actually put it on the stage. It's more lighting.
No. stand up on your feet. We would love for you guys to join in with some praise and some worship to our King with us tonight. Is that okay?
It's all right.
Good. Oh, you turn to the person next to you, tell them that you love their numbers. Now, tell them that you love their outfits. Tell them they look great tonight.
Earth has no sorrow that know we have, sometimes we come to our wits and we have nothing. But it's at that point where God just says, come to me. It's in those moments in time where the Spirit calls, come to me. So if we're in this place tonight where you're at that point, the King is right here. Right here, right here, right now. This is your prayer tonight. Sing with us. Take him to the King.
Take me to the King. I don't have much to breathe.
Even if I try,
to the King. My story and a little bit about where I come from. I'm going to try really hard not to cry, because this is just a bit of a crying story. I haven't actually spoken about it just yet. It's a bit fresh. But so as Ladine said before, I come from Australia. It's all right, you don't have to fake it. Okay. So I come from Australia, I come from Sydney, Australia. But as Ladine said, yes, I am half Kiwi. So yeah, I spent a lot of time growing up coming to New Zealand and I hated it. I thought it was so boring because of that town. And but I love it now. I love New Zealand. It is a real honor and privilege for me to be here and to share this platform with such amazing people. Yeah, just to share my heart, be able to worship and do that in your space. So thank you for having me. So I'm going to share a little bit about my story. So yes, I come from Sydney, Australia. And I grew up there my whole life. And growing up, I had a really awesome childhood. You know those kids that you look at school and you're like, man, they got it. They got it good. You know, two parents, you love them. They got all they could ever need. And not everything that you want, but you know, everything that you needed. I grew up in a safe, secure space. Really, really, really happy, beautiful childhood. And I come from a family that loves to travel. So I spent a lot of time as a kid, you know, traveling all over the world, because that's what my parents did, you know. A lot of families, they save for different things, you know, fancy houses, fancy cars. My parents save for the holidays. So we spent weeks and weeks and weeks overseas, and just really beautiful memories, really awesome time. And when I was about 13 years old, my dad got really sick, and you know, I remember sitting there, and I was only 13, and you know, my parents coming home and telling us that my dad wasn't well, and that he had cancer and all those kinds of things, and it was only 9 months later that he passed away. So I was 13 years old, and you know, had this amazing life, this amazing family and childhood, and then all of a sudden that was torn apart, for me anyway. I remember feeling like everything was over. The whole world had ended because this had now ended. And it was hard. I remember just thinking, oh, I just want it to be, you know, a year or 2 years later, I just want to be over this yuckiness that I feel, you know, trying to get, I just wanted it to be happy land again, you know, but it wasn't. This was now, you know, what my life was gonna be. And by any means, it wasn't a bad life. It was a bold life still. You know, my mom was amazing. And so carried on, I had an amazing opportunity to join Endless Praise, which I did when I was 17 years old. And I stayed in that ministry for 10 years. And full-time ministry on the road, away from my home, away from my family, just doing ministry. And it changed my life, made me who I am today. It taught me so much, and it showed me how real God is. You know, people always say to me, how do you know that God is real? And I said, you have no idea what I've experienced. Being on the road for 10 years, the way that you have to rely on God is just incredible. And no one can ever take away from me what I've experienced. And I know without a shadow of a doubt how real God is, because I have experienced Him in that way. God is so real. And so we would travel around, and I would sing this song that I'm going to share with you tonight. And I would share this testimony and sing about, you know, how faithful God is. You know, when I would look back at that time when I was 13 years old and just see how faithful God had been to me, you know, keeping our family together and being there with us through that time. And I would sing this everywhere that I would go. And now we move to me today as a 32-year-old. And, you know, a couple of years ago, my mom got sick. And here we go. And the whole process started. And, you know, my mom passed away in March. And you know what, guys? I don't focus on the tears. Focus on the words. I now had to live what I had sung for all those years. I had told everyone around the world how faithful God was. You know, and it was easy to do because I was an adult. I wasn't 13. I wasn't 13 anymore. I was looking back and reliving that and seeing God in that. And now here I was in this all over again. You know, I never thought that I would be 32 with no parents, but I am. And that's okay. That is okay because I have Jesus. You know what? God is so faithful to me, guys. God is so, so faithful. I can tell you, to go through this again is probably the hardest thing I've ever had to do. But God is so faithful. He is so faithful. He has once again walked every single step of the journey with me again. And you know, there's a story in the Bible about two guys, they're walking back to this town called Emmaus. And Jesus has just died. Their best friend. They're everything. He has just died. And these two men are walking and this man starts coming and walking along with them. And he turns to them and he says, "What's wrong with you guys?" Because they look really down. And they say, "Haven't you heard? You know that guy that everyone's been talking about? That guy, our guy, Jesus, he's gone. He passed away." They kept walking back to Emmaus. And once they got there, they invited this strange man into their home to come and share a meal with them. And the Bible reads that as they are sitting around and they are about to give thanks for the food, that this man, he broke the bread and their eyes were open and they realized that it was Jesus himself that was sitting there right in front of them. So many times, guys, we are walking to Emmaus. I have been walking to Emmaus for like 3 years. You know, it's a hard road. But trust me when I tell you, whatever it is that your road is, it might not even be someone losing someone. It could be anything. Know that God is walking with you. He is walking right there next to you like he was with those two guys doing this. Sometimes we don't see him or feel him or know him. But trust and believe that he is walking that way with you because the God that we serve is a faithful one. So if anything, I want you to feel uplifted and I want you to feel encouraged to know that this is what is, you know, this is what has come to pass in my life with Jesus. And the same God that I serve is the same one that you do too. So be encouraged, okay? This song is called Emmaus. And I really do hope that it's a smooth bar to salt.
So fair. Thank you. To my knees will I fall. Richard and your lives are blessed. I love what's on the backdrop here. It says harvest. It's time. Can you turn to the person next to you and say, it is time. It is time. It's time. Harvest. Whenever I think of that word harvest, I think of this word mission. Can you say mission with me? One, two, three. Mission. And as I begin to think about mission, I love what Jesus says in the word where he says, I am the way, the truth, and the what? The light. He also says that you, talking to his disciples and his followers, that you are the light of the what? The world. And as I think of this concept of light, I love when I grew up, I actually grew up in the church, and I love going to the school that we went to out west, the White Tech, and they went to school. Yeah, White Tech. Very small school. I think we had about two classrooms, and there was about 30 kids in total. So you can pretty much be everyone. But I loved the songs that we sang, and one of the songs that I loved singing was the song "This Little Light of Mine." And just from an early age, I had this idea that we were to be the light. That our purpose as Jesus followers is to be this shining light. But as I grew up, I noticed something very interesting, and that's this. Is that we love to shine light where there's already light. We love to shine light where the light already is. And I just want to share this verse with us all. It's in John chapter 1. And John says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him, all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The light shines where? In the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Did you know that light shines best in darkness? Light shines best in darkness. So as you're thinking about this idea, this theme of harvest, I'm telling you right now that the harvest isn't where the light is shining. The harvest is in the darkness. And I know the darkness is messy. The darkness is scary. The darkness is going to call you out of your comfort zone, but that's why Jesus said that I am the light, because it's not you that's going to shine the light, it's Jesus shining his light through your life. So this song that we're going to be sharing is a song called Use Me. The song talks about this desire and this passion to be used by God, and it talks about the story of Moses when God used him to free the Egyptians. To free the Israelites from the Egyptians. And this man who was once afraid and who once was scared, but God said, "What is in your hand?" And he said, "This is my staff." And God used him. And I'm going to tell you tonight that God can use you to shine your light in darkness. So our prayer as we sing this song is to challenge you to think, what is the dark places that God is calling you to shine your light? And shine that light as bright as you can for God.
Use anything, Lord. Work that you do for them. us as young people and as in our communities and in our church, we just thank you so much for that. Please bless Mark and the future he has for this coming year. That'll go all smoothly for him. That'll be just so wonderful, and he'll be so, have such a relaxed and blessed year.
Father God, I just want to thank you so much for this man, this powerful man of God, this man of you, Lord, and he's ministered to so many young people, not only in this conference, but other conferences, and we just thank you so much that, he is on a next journey, a next chapter in his life, and we just know that you have so much more in store for him. We know that you have so much more in store for his journey and his family. And so, I just want to pray a blessing over him, Lord, as he steps into this next chapter, Lord, that he would, just continue to be used by you and for your glory. So we just pray a blessing over Lance. We pray a blessing over our young people, Lord, who have been influenced, who have been impacted by his ministry. And, just so grateful, so privileged to be here with him and to share this experience with him. And so, we just lay it before you, Lord, and we just ask that you'll just cover with your power, with your love, with your mercy, with your grace, with your spirit. So I pray in your name. Amen.
And everyone said, amen. Amen. Thanks so
here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Adriel.
Thank you. why I just